Kelley, when you and I last spoke, loud budgeting was a trend. Is being vocal about your finances still a thing?
Yes, Larissa, we did talk about this. You were a trendsetter with that one. It still is on point. I love that people are continuing this social media trend of being honest about their finances, talking about it, saying no. So, for example, a lot of people are talking about instead of going out for an expensive dinner with their family, they might host a potluck. Or what about going for a walk instead of some expensive drinks out? So I love that this trend is happening. There's a couple more out that I've seen recently. Leslie Scorgi came out with an article on the $1 rule. So basically, if per use what you're spending money on is less than a dollar, she says you're good to buy it. So, for example, we're in that kind of fast fashion trend right now where you might get a pair of shoes for $50, but you're only wearing them twice. So, in her words, no, you wouldn't buy it because that's going to cost you $25 per use. But maybe a more expensive pair at $350 that you're going to wear 400 times, that gets you down to under a dollar. And then lastly, Larissa, I've also seen some articles on something called reverse budgeting. I love this trend. This is where you take all of your expenses, your fixed and otherwise, and then what you want to save up for. If it's a house, if it's a car, if it's a vacation, whatever that amount is, whatever you have left over at the end of the month, that's what you're free to spend. So it's that reversing out the budgeting. Hopefully, one of those works for your viewers or for their adult kids that they might be talking about budgeting this summer.
Let's talk about the current climate. What is the financial health of Canadians when you take a look at what's happening right now? How are Canadians managing?
Well, Canadians are still feeling really stressed. Interest rates are still high. You know, it's an expensive time of year. We're going into summer. You want to actually have some fun with your money. A TransUnion survey came out showing that credit card use is actually on the rise. It's being led by those that are new to the country and Gen Z, totaling $2.38 trillion. The National Payroll Institute, their surveys reveal that 63% of Canadians are spending their entire paycheck just to stay afloat. Over 30% are actually spending more than that. How are they doing it? Going into debt, of course. And I think it's really important as well that the NPI survey revealed that over 30% of those that are earning $100,000 or more are feeling financially stressed, Larissa. So it's not just frontline workers, it's those that are earning a really decent income are still feeling stressed. So it's definitely a tough time going into the summer when you're juggling mortgage rates or high rents or just still the very high cost of everything.
It is the start of summer 2024, typically filled with travel, vacations, maybe weddings, backyard projects. What should you be considering this season?
Well, definitely your budget. BMO came out with a survey recently and half admitted to spending more than they should. And, you know, 85% in that survey felt that they were actually doing okay financially, that they were, you know, had a firm footing. But 15% of them, and I certainly can put my hand up at times, said that impulse buying is derailing their finances. So this survey looked at, you know, how much people are spending 15% more on renos, 20% more on travel. One in 10 are actually looking at splurges like a car. That's a big splurge. So please get some financial advice before you just go out and get a car. You're probably the most, if not second most expensive purchase you'll make. And 15% are looking at spending more on things like summer camp for their kids. So yes, this is a time to really look at your finances. How are you going to afford all that extra spending? Hopefully you're not putting it on a high interest rate credit card, or you're calling your bank and you're getting into a lower interest rate credit card. And of course, looking at those bank fees anywhere, Larissa, that you can save some extra money.
Kelley, you had mentioned that interest rates are still high. We do know that the Bank of Canada has initiated that rate cut cycle. If you're thinking about home ownership. What do you need to know if you want to qualify for that mortgage? And is there such a thing as having too much mortgage?
Well, certainly it's harder for some people to qualify, but to your point, Larysa, yes, some people are approved for more than they actually can afford. How is that possible? Maybe your parents helped you with the down payment. That's amazing, but you don't want to take more mortgage than you can afford because it's you at the end of the day having to pay the maintenance fees, everything else, you know, what comes with home ownership or maybe having a condo. So Rob McLister actually has a great article with the Financial Post app on the regret and how having too much mortgage can actually put you into an early grave. That stress is really mounting. So definitely, you know, it is a tough time for home buyers right across the country. You know, prices are still incredibly high. But what's interesting in his articles, he talked about 33% of those that got a mortgage actually have regret. 72% say that they think their property is going to increase over the next 12 months. And 58% actually said that, you know, like hoping for appreciation got them into a mortgage that was a little bit more than they could afford. And, you know, you also have to look at how long are places sitting on the market in your city. So even if it's appreciated on paper, it doesn't mean that you'll be able to sell it for the price that you want. So, you know, if you're planning to get a mortgage or you're going into a renewal, you definitely want to sit down with a professional, get some help. And also, Larysa, it's really important that if you're coming up for a renewal or buying your first home, that you remember you can negotiate your rate. It's estimated that 68% of those age 18 to 34, they're feeling very stressed about their you know, housing situation and very likely not to negotiate their rate because they're just so happy to get into a home. So I was a banker over 20 years ago, and back then it was hard to shop around for interest rates. You had to physically go into the bank. You couldn't even call to see what the competition was charging. Now you can just go on the internet, but just because it's the posted rate doesn't mean you can't negotiate a better rate.
You had mentioned reverse budgeting earlier on. Leave us with some final thoughts. How do you stay on track, keep on track?
You know what, Larysa, it's balance like everything else, right? You've got to track your purchases. You've got to figure out a baseline. I mean, if you don't know what you spent last year, it's hard to have a budget this year. So, you know, do your best to find free activities, fun activities, but remember, have a great summer, but keep in mind what you'll be dealing with in the fall. So stick to your goals, set some goals if you don't have them, and make the most of your money this very precious season.